Mr. President of the Senate, my very distinguished colleagues, I'm Senator George Thompson Sekibo. I represent the Rivers East Central District. Mr. President, the motion on curbing soot particulate droppings, health hazard concern, and economic sabotage by illegal refining of crude product in Rivers State. It is co-sponsored by other seven senators, and now including Senator Gashon Bassi, whose name was inadvertently omitted among the names. Mr. President and my colleagues, permit me to move the motion. The Senate notes that the droppings of unidentified sooty particulate in Rivers State, which are suspected to be after effect of incomplete crude refining process, has taken a more dangerous dimension. Aware that oil and gas exploration and exploitation activities are in River State and its environs since the discovery of hydrocarbons in the Niger Delta region in 1957. Aware also that the environment, including land, water, and air, has already been grievously polluted through the activities of the multinational companies. Aware further that an environmental audit due to the degradation of the environment has never been carried out since the commencement of the exploration and exploration activities in the area, which has lasted for over 60 years, meaning that the contaminated environment remains without the hope of remediation. Worried that the sooty particulate substances dropping in the state is becoming too visible, that one cannot stay outdoors without receiving drops of them on his body. It has become more worrisome that they are seen on bedspreads in bedrooms, worktops in kitchens, chairs and other materials in houses, meaning that they are entering through every available crevice into inner spaces of buildings as the wind carries them. Concerned that residents in River State have noticed lots of these sooty particulates settling in their nasal tracts, which has occasioned cleaning of their nostril several times in the day. Concerned further that the amount of these particulates being inhaled daily by Nigerians resident in the state cannot be estimated, just as the after effects of the inhalation have not been determined. The stuff that the sooty particulates are dropping on water bodies, farmland, and whatever is left open under the sky, which is detrimental to human health, as residents in the area are exposed to consumption of harvest from both the sea and the land, as well as drinking rainwater and water from streams and rivers. Mr. President, the Senate is further worried that these particulates, which are suspected to be byproduct of hydrocarbons or crude oil that did not go through proper refining process in complete combustion, may contain some chemicals that can prove health hazard to the people. Knows that air pollution has no boundary or limit within which it could be contained, as means of containment of air pollution has not been discovered. Therefore, the possibility of this sooty particulate spreading to other neighboring states, and indeed the entire nation, cannot be overemphasized. Mr. President, it is needed to observe that recent outbreak of difficulty in breathing caused by congestion of nasal tracts of many residents in River State could be linked to this epidemic. Observes further that this may also be the cause of recent causes of death with noticeable ailment in many towns in River State. Knows further that it could become a national emergency if not handled. Mr. President, note further that it could become a national emergency if not handled appropriately from East Route. Hence, the urgent need to curb the causes of the occurrences, avert their likely side effect on human beings and environment, as is teaching time saves nine. informed that pockets of illegal crude refining were recently discovered all over River State, who use all sorts of methods to refine crude for local consumption. These activities have increased pollution in the already polluted environment. Further informed that the crude being used to refine petroleum products in these illegal activities is through crude pilfering, causing colossal national waste and economic sabotage. Believe that some security agents posted to secure these national assets have turned themselves to partners in this deadly illegal act, thus giving the criminals impetus to openly commit these national economic crimes. Understand that River State government has taken a bold step to fish out these criminals for prosecution, as well as destroy such illegal substandard refineries with a view to stopping these illegal activities and crimes. Aware that the issue of clean environment is one of the fundamental objectives and derivative principle of state policy of the Nigerian state as provided in Section 20 of 1999 Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria as amended, which states inter alia that the state shall protect and improve the environment and safeguard the water, air and land, forests and wildlife of Nigeria. The Senate is also aware that the 1999 Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria as amended within the context of the social order in Section 17.2d has admonished that exploitation of natural resources to the detriment of the citizen shall be prevented as shown below. Exploitation of human or natural resources in any form whatsoever for reasons other than the good of the community shall be prevented. The Senate recalls that in order to forestall this type of emergency or occurrence and other hazardous pollution that may occasion due to the oil and gas exploration activities, the federal government set up the National Oil Spill Detection and Response Agency, NOSDRA, in 2006, with the following three cardinal objectives, among others, as provided in Section 5A, B, and C in its Enabling Act. Five, the objective of the agency shall be to coordinate and implement the National Oil Spill Contingency Plan for Nigeria in this article referred to as the plan. A, safe, timely, effective and appropriate response to major or disastrous oil pollution. B, identify high-risk area as well as priorities areas for protection and cleanup. C, establish the mechanism to monitor and assist or where expedient direct the response, including the capability to mobilize the necessary resources to save lives, protect threatened environment, and clean up the best practical extent of the impacted sites. The Senate recalls also that as provided in Section 6 of the Establishing Act, NOSRA is also saddled with the responsibility of carrying out surveillance, coordinating issues on oil spillage and associated pollution, as well as implementing such plans as will be issued by the federal government. Dismayed that NOSRA, with the huge responsibility of preparedness, detection, and response to oil spillage, pollution due to oil refinery activities in the country, has not lived up to its mandate of the surveillance, monitoring, and has therefore not informed the nation of these occurring national epidemics, while Nigerian citizens are suffocating due to this epidemic. The stop that unduly delay in proffering the necessary solution to eradicate this illegality is drastically affecting the lives of the residents in the River State. This is worse than physical insecurity being combated, as the particulate fumes affect every person without creed or color, ethnicity or religion, and demands that the security agents who involve themselves in this act of national sabotage be given appropriate sanctions and other perpetrators be treated as economic saboteurs. Mr. Senate President and my distinguished colleagues, accordingly, the Senate resolve as follows. Urge the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria to note that there is an impending environmental danger that is occurring in Rivers State and its environs, orchestrated by miscreants who are engaged in illegal refining as well as looting national crude oil assets. Two, urge the President to audit security agencies who are saddled with the responsibilities of securing these assets but are involved in this national sabotage and be sanctioned appropriately by the laws of the country. Three, urge the President to use his constitutional powers to support the government of Rivers State, who have started to combat these criminal activities and fish out these national economic saboteurs. Four, direct the Senior Committee on Navy, Police Affairs, Interior and Army to carry out holistic investigation of these illegal activities with a view to ascertaining the involvement of security agencies collaborating and abetting in these dastardly acts and report within 4 weeks. And five, and final, further direct its Committee on Environment, Petroleum Upstream, and Primary Health to visit the Rivers State and carry out observatory assessment of the level of damage these activities have caused the environment and the health concern the activities have occasioned, as well as suggest solutions and report within 4 weeks. Mr. President, I so move. Thank you very much.
Yes, Mr. Senator. I urge the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria to note that there is an impending environmental danger that is occurring in River State and its environs, orchestrated by miscreants who are engaged in illegal refining as well as looting national crude oil assets. Those in favor, prayer one, say aye. Those against, say nay, the ayes. Prayer two, urge the President to audit security agencies who are saddled with the responsibility of securing these assets, but are involved in this national sabotage and be sanctioned appropriately by the laws of the country. Has that been established? Was anybody caught and confirmed? Then the law should take its course now. Why are you saying we should tell President? The court should prosecute them. Because what you are saying is those that are involved in this national sabotage, and be sanctioned. If there is nothing like sanction, they should be tried in court. Leg, go to the second leg. No. You are talking about those involved. Huh? So if you say those involved, have we caught anybody?
Those who are
Okay. I just thought we should make it watertight. Then we should ask for prosecution, isn't it? I don't know whether that's what you want. They should be prosecuted. If anybody is arrested, that person should be prosecuted. But I will put the question as it is. Those in favor that's in favor of prayer two, say aye. Those against, say nay, the same. Prayer three, urge the President to use his constitutional powers to support the government of River State, who have started to combat these criminal activities and fish out these national economic saboteurs. Those in favor of prayer three, say aye.
Aye.
Those against, say nay. The ayes have it. Prayer four, direct the Senate committees on the Navy, Police Force, Interior, and Army to carry out holistic investigation of these illegal activities with a view to ascertaining the involvement of security agencies collaborating and abetting in these dastardly acts and report within 4 weeks. Not yet, please. I don't want to be part of the debate, but why are you so particular about security agencies? Why can't we make it a little bit open? Because you need the security agencies to even do your assignment. And if all you are going to do is to investigate them, how do you think they will support you? Huh? Yeah, you can, but if you particularize it, it's going to be tough for you. Okay, please.
Fourth, in this dastardly act, and report within 4 weeks.
Amendment. Senator, those against Senate, I say. Prayer 5, further direct his committees on environment, petroleum upstream, and petroleum and primary health care to visit River State and carry out observatory assessment of the level of damage these activities have caused the environment and the health concern of the activities have occasioned, as well as suggest solution and report within 4 weeks. Those in favor of this prayer say aye. Those against any, the ayes have it. Sorry? Okay, additional prayers, Senator Issa Jibril.